In the previous videos, we talked a lot about classification and how we can implement multilayer perceptrons for classifying data points. Now you might wonder if we can use multilayer perceptrons also for regression analysis. And the answer is yes, we can. And in this video, I want to give you a brief outline how it works conceptually. So suppose we have a simple regression data set as shown here, where we have the feature values on the x-axis and the target values on the y-axis. Now, here's an example of a linear regression line. So suppose we use a linear regression model and apply it to that data set. So the straight line here, what you see, is the linear regression model. So it takes in the feature values and it predicts the target values, of course. And here's how a regression fit might look like using a multilayer perceptron. And as you can see, it fits the data quite well. Multilayer neural networks are actually pretty good at fitting data, which is also sometimes a little bit dangerous because it can, of course, also easily lead to overfitting. So when we are using multilayer perceptrons for regression, we have to specifically make sure that we don't overfit the data. However, in this particular case, it looks actually pretty good and it captures the trends in the data pretty well. So how do we actually have to modify our multilayer perceptron architecture so that it works for regression instead of classification problems? So here, just to briefly recap, is again the multilayer perceptron architecture for classification. So we have the net inputs at the input layer, the Z's, which go then into the hidden layers. And then at the output layer here, we have the softmax activation, which returns the class membership probabilities. The class membership probabilities are then passed to the argmax function, which returns the predicted class label. Now, the good news is for regression, the model is actually much simpler. We can get rid of the softmax activation and the argmax here at the output layer, because now we are not interested in class labels anymore, but continuous values. So instead of having all this, the softmax and argmax in the output layer, we just need a continuous output now. And the architecture for regression would look like as follows, where we still have the net inputs on the left-hand side, followed by the hidden layers. And as you can see here, the corresponding architecture for regression is a little bit simpler than the classification architecture. So here for reference is a ball and stick representation of the multilayer perceptron for classification. The multilayer perceptron here takes two input features, has one hidden layer consisting of 4 units, and has an output layer consisting of 3 units. So this would be a multilayer perceptron for a data set with 3 classes, because it has 3 output nodes. And here for reference now is a multilayer perceptron for regression. Again, we have the two input features, the hidden layer consisting of the 4 units, but now we only have 1 output node. And that's because we don't predict class labels anymore, we are now only returning a continuous value. So in a sense, the multilayer perceptron for regression is very similar to the multilayer perceptron for classification, except that the regression model is actually even simpler because we don't need all the output nodes. We only need 1 output node. So what does the loss function for regression now look like? For classification, we usually use the cross entropy loss. And for regression, the most commonly used loss function is the mean squared error. So the mean squared error computes the difference between the actual target and the predicted target value. And actually we compute the squared difference so that the sign, whether it's positive or negative, does not matter here. So then after computing these squared distances, we average those over all the training examples in the training data set. And yeah, that's in a nutshell how multilayer perceptrons can be applied to a regression data set. In the next video, we will walk through a hands-on code example illustrating it with a concrete data set.